Okay, on
for the Q&A. Oh my god, can I get up to my desk, please? All right, what is up, guys? Today I'm gonna be doing the Q&A. I had a questions video thingamajiggly out 2 weeks ago, and you guys asked quite a bit of questions. I didn't get all of them, but here, I got a little folder here, as you can see, and let's go ahead and open it up. We got 22 questions, so hope you guys enjoy it. All right, cool. Number one question I have is, do you answer questions? Question number two, why are you? Honestly, I'm not really sure. Why am I? Question number three, please be a good one. What doing? All right, question number four. Let's hope this is a real question. And it is, are you a ghost?
Maybe.
Sixth question, or next question. I'm not really sure what I'm on yet. But how much do you play Skate 3? Okay, so this is an honest question. I appreciate it. How much do I play Skate 3? Honestly, recently I haven't been playing it too much. I've been playing a lot of Valorant and Osu, I'm not gonna lie. But when I was playing Skate 3, I was playing it for like at least 24/7, I'm not gonna lie. But I'm not really sure. Now I don't really play it that much. So hopefully that answers your question. Question number seven, what is your favorite video game? See, now this is a really hard question to answer, you know, like honestly the hardest question that I could possibly ever answer, and I'm not really sure how to answer this one. So you guys let me know in the comments below what my favorite video game is, because I really, man, I couldn't tell you guys, honestly. Like, it's really, I don't know, man, like whatever, you know. Question number eight is, what do you use to record? And I use OBS to record. Sometimes I use the Elgato software if I'm recording my Xbox screen. I have my Elgato plugged into my computer and it's recording my Xbox through OBS. Question number nine, I think. I'm not really sure what question I'm on, but are there books in a library? No. Question number 10, I'm pretty sure. Will you do another collab with any creators in Skate community? Please collab again with Mystix. That would be lit. Will do another collab? I'm pretty sure. I hope I do another collab and collab with Mystix again. That would be dope. Mystix, if you're watching this video, let me know if you want to do another collab, bro, because that would be lit. I'm not really sure if he wants to, but yeah, that would be pretty dope, you know. You never know, it could happen one of these days, but who knows. Speak of the devil, here's Mystix with a question. What do you like to do when not recording or gaming, like any sports or any hobbies? Well, I don't really do anything else, to be honest. Like, I kind of sit here all day, but when I want to do something, I usually like go bowling or something. I like bowling a lot, I'm not gonna lie, guys. I like bowling a lot, pretty fun. I used to go to the skate park. I didn't skateboard, you know, I'm a scooter kid. Question number 12, I think. What kind of vehicle do you drive? What is your dream car? Well, at the moment, I don't drive anything. I'm not gonna front. I don't drive anything. I'm 17 and I don't even have my driver's license yet. But my dream car, honestly don't know, to be honest. Question number 13 from Wanted. Who inspired you to start Skate 3 content? Honestly, nobody. I'm not gonna lie. I kind of inspired myself to do Skate 3 content because I just enjoyed the game that much. So myself. But I will say there are content creators that definitely inspired me to keep going with Skate 3, and that would be by Mystix, Cowplex, Epic Flying Horse, you know, the main content creators in Skate 3. Just watching, you know, them grow and stuff like that and talking to them definitely inspired me to keep doing Skate 3. So I definitely want to go ahead and shout them out. So thank you for, you know, inspiring me to keep playing this game, making content for it. I'm gonna do a little water break here. If you guys are new to this channel, go ahead and subscribe. Also like the video, because I would really appreciate it. Okay, I drank my water. I don't know if you guys did, but next question. You can collab with anybody in the Skate 3 community. Who would it be? Now this says if you can collab with anyone, and I would say ZexyZek. Like that, dude, that would be insane. If I collab with ZexyZek, that would probably never, ever, ever happen. But it would be ZexyZek. I mean, who wouldn't want to collab with ZexyZek? You know what I mean? So yeah, I would say ZexyZek. Question number 15 is, have you ever broken a controller over Skate? If so, please tell. Now, I'm not going to lie about this. I don't think I've ever broke a controller over Skate 3. But I definitely have over other games, such as Call of Duty. Question number 16. Wow, we're actually running through these like crazy. Did you ever expect for you to be where you are now, and what do you expect in the future? To be honest, I did not think I was gonna hit 10,000 subs. I was rooting for 200 or 100. I don't even remember. One of my Q&As, I said it. I started this channel back in like 2013 or something, but I posted my first video like 3 years ago. But when I actually started uploading consistently, like I was uploading every single day. I'm not even joking. I was uploading every single day. And my goal was like 100 subs in 1 month. And I'm pretty sure I wanted 100 subs in 1 month. And somehow, I'm not like, I don't even know. Somehow I got 1,000 in 1 month. So thank you guys so much for that. And no, I did not expect me to be at 10,000. So I want to thank you guys from the bottom of my heart that I'm at 10,000. It is a huge milestone. Thank you guys so much. Next question. Are you secretly X7 Albert? I hope not. I really hope I am not X7 Albert. So I'm going to say no. And do you like Dino Nuggies? I don't think I had Dino Nuggies for a very long time, but chicken nuggets in general are pretty good. So I would say yes. So yeah. And then he said, this is a legit question. What's your dream job? I don't really have a dream job, but it would be lit if YouTube could be my job in the future, because right now it's not. It's just like a, you know, something to do. So yeah. But yeah, I'm sorry. I can't really answer that because I don't know. Question number 18. What do you think of SkateCom or SKATECom? I'm pretty sure he means community. And am I your favorite? Well, I don't think you're my favorite, but you're definitely cool. And in the SkateCom, what do I think about it? I think the SkateCom is pretty cool. I mean, you know, they're pretty cool people. Skate is definitely something that is not easy, and I think skate players should definitely get more, I don't really know the word, but they should definitely get recognized more, because skate is not as easy as people think, especially if you are hitting like 1260s and stuff. I'm pretty sure it's 1260s and 1440s. That's literally insane. So I think skate players should definitely get more recognition in the community. I'm pretty sure that's the word. I don't really know. You know, they should be more noticed. So shout out to the skate players, by the way. Question number 19 is, when will you buy me a 3090? Now, for some reason, Schwang thinks I own about 70 houses. So he wants me to sell one of my houses to buy him a 3090. But I'm not going to lie, I live behind McDonald's in a dumpster. So I don't think I'm going to be able to afford a 3090 for you. But maybe one day, you know, maybe one day, maybe like, and like when I'm dead. So yeah, I'll get you it in like about like 3,000 years. Question number 20 comes from Skies. And what is your favorite color? By the way, I love your content. My favorite color, honestly, I have two favorite colors, and that would be blue and green. Originally, my favorite color was blue, but then I started liking green, and I liked green throughout my entire life after. So I really just like both colors. Green and blue are probably like my favorite colors. So I would say green and blue. If I had to choose a side, I'd probably say green. So yeah. Question number 21 comes from Epic Flying Horse. Shout out to Epic Flying Horse, by the way. And he asked, if you could be the best in the world at one thing, what would it be? Now, this is a really hard question for me to answer because I really don't know. But back to what I was saying earlier, I really like bowling. So if I could be the best in the world at bowling, that would be insane. That would honestly be insane. So I would say that, but at the same time, I don't really know, so I can't really answer it, but I kind of did. Thank you for asking me a question, Epic Flying Horse. Question number 22. Man, we're flying by these things. These things are just, I don't even know. These things are just flying by. All right. Anyways, I don't know why that guy asked that on the top. Exactly. Bro moment, Drifty. Thank you for the response. You know, he honestly answered that question right there. But actual question from Drifty is, do you enjoy making skaters, still considering how the methods have changed and how long you have been doing it? So honestly, the methods wise, I definitely like the older method on the RGH. This new method kind of pisses me off. I really do not enjoy making skaters on the computer on the new method because of how easy it was on the RGH. So I would say no to that part on the methods. Now, how long I've been doing it? Yes, it does get a little annoying because I've been doing it for so long, but I definitely enjoy making skaters in a way because, first of all, it benefits me with YouTube, and it benefits me with the game. I mean, like, I like playing the game. So if I get on and I'm always having a new skater, it is amazing. I don't have to worry about having a plain skater all the time. I don't care how many people have my skater, you know. That's why I just make these skaters. So I really don't care how many people have it. You know, some people don't like having the same skater as other people, but I really don't care. So I always have a new skater. And that is probably the best part of making skaters, to be honest. I mean, it's really nice. And, you know, it's also growing my YouTube channel. I can't complain. It's a half and half, to be honest. I'm not going to lie. And unfortunately, we are down to the very last question. The last question is by Dark Gan. And he said, are you happy doing YouTube, or has it become something you feel like you have to do? Now, this is a very interesting question, okay? So I am happy and not happy at the same time. I'm not gonna lie to you guys. I'm happy for doing YouTube, okay? I am happy for doing it. I also have a little bit of a feeling that I have to do it. And that is because of how big my channel is in a way. I'm not like famous YouTuber or anything, okay? But I definitely have those times where I feel like I have to do it. And I force myself to. But most of the time, I try to keep myself motivated and happy about doing it. I feel like the main thing is the imports definitely bring me down sometimes. Like I was saying before, I do and don't like doing the imports. I want to do other content. I've been saying that I've been wanting to do other content since like 500 subs, and I never have because I never had the motivation to do anything else. Because imports, they're easy and not easy, but the imports are something that I'm good at doing, I guess, and I am used to doing. Switching up to something else is definitely scary, but obviously you always have to commit to changes and stuff. So I'm not really sure on this question, but I guess I kind of answered it. So yes and no, kind of like the last question, yes and no. So it's a very mixed question, but I hope YouTube comes to the point where I enjoy it so much to the point that I just want to keep uploading and keep doing it, because it does get demotivating. Okay, YouTube does get demotivating. So yeah, I just didn't want to lie to you guys. I want to keep it 100% authentic. All right, cool. All right, guys. So looking at the screen now, we have done 1, 2, 3. All right, I'm not going to count all of them. We got 23 questions done. That is definitely not all the questions, but I don't want to answer about 50 questions. I really don't want to do that. I mean, I don't even have that many, but I don't want to answer too many questions because the video is going to be like 5 hours long. So if you guys did enjoy the video, let me know in the comments whether video you guys would like to see next. Video ideas, game ideas, challenges, whatever. Also join the Discord in the description below. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. I hope you guys subscribe to the channel if you're new, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace out.